Prevalence is the number of people living in a population who have had a cancer diagnosis during a set period of time. Prevalence includes a lot of people who are at very different stages of their cancer journey. Some of the people have been told very recently that they have cancer and are starting their treatments. Others are years past their diagnosis and are now living normal lives other than having regular medical follow-up. Prevalence is sometimes shown as a percentage, such as 5% of the province, or a number out of 100,000. It can also be shown as the number of people living with cancer in an area, which can be useful for planning how many hospital beds or nurses to help people with cancer each year. Here's an example of how prevalence works. In this case, we'll be looking at 5-year prevalence. In other words, anyone alive in a population who was told they had cancer sometime in the last 5 years. During the first year, one person was diagnosed with cancer. During the second year, another person was diagnosed with cancer. One of the people with cancer died not long after being diagnosed. And there were no new cases of cancer diagnosed in the fourth or fifth years. When we make our prevalence measurement at the end of 5 years, there are 9 people living, one of whom has cancer. So our 5-year cancer prevalence is one person with cancer in a population of 9, or about 11%. Here's an example of prevalence using real data. In this case, we're looking at 10-year prevalence, and we're seeing the total number of people living with cancer in Ontario who were diagnosed in the last 10 years. This graph shows that the cancer types with the highest prevalence are cancers that are very common, in other words, they have high incidence rates, and tend to be the ones that have good survival, such as prostate and breast cancer. We see that although lung cancer is common, its prevalence is lower, mainly because this type of cancer is usually caught late and its survival is worse. What does it mean when we see changes in prevalence? Prevalence increases when there are more new cancer cases, so increasing incidence, or if people are able to live longer after being diagnosed with cancer, so improved survival. In other words, a cancer with high survival usually has high prevalence because many people diagnosed with that cancer live for a long time after being diagnosed. Measuring prevalence allows us to understand how to best help people who've been diagnosed with cancer. Knowing a cancer's prevalence means we can plan for how many people with a certain cancer will need treatment, long-term follow-up, care, and support based on how long it's been since they were diagnosed. For example, someone who's in the middle of having chemotherapy will have very different needs than someone who finished their treatment years before and has now returned to a normal routine.